So check it out, link in the description. This is what we have right now. Hello everyone, welcome back to the Fruity Mall channel. Yeah, it's been a while, so today let's do another tutorial. I think this is going to be a really fun tutorial, but first, for those who don't know, I've been working with Dutch vlogger Aartos. For those who know him, for those who don't know him, I think he's a really great guy, a really cool guy, and I'm working with him on creating his first own hardstyle track. And I believe it's going to be a really nice one. So if you're interested in that, stay tuned, because I think it's really cool. I'm also in maybe two or three of his vlogs, and you can also see the @FruityMosses on Instagram, so don't forget to follow him or me. There's a link in the description. So for this video, I have noticed a lot of people still are still struggling with sidechaining. I will do another video on that, but first let's focus on another difficult part, layering. So most of you might have heard the term stack the layers, you know, stack the layers, that's sounds like a really cool techno vocal. So yeah, but it's not simply stacking layers. There's a thing to it. So in this tutorial, I will also be explaining my own preset bank for Silent One. Now you might think, he's trying to sell it or whatever. Yeah, sure, because it's really cool. So let me show you. There have been some people, not a lot, but saying a lot of my leads, not in this version, but in the previous version of my bank, sound very similar. Now, this is true, because I don't know about you, but I also have this plugin called VPS Avenger and also Nexus. But in the case of VPS Avenger, when I play a sound in there, it instantly sounds done. It's complete. You have reverb, delay, everything is done. And for me, that just doesn't work. When I make a melody, I want to have full control over my own mixing. That's reverb, delay, all that kind of crap. I only want the blank, clean, clear sound, the basic sound. So that's my bank. For those who are serious about layering, with this bank you can honestly recreate every sound you have ever heard in hardstyle, as long as you know how to layer it. So that's why this tutorial, let's show you. So I made a quick MIDI based on an old TV series I once watched, Due South. It's really cool. It's about a Mountie. Okay, so it should sound like this. So this melody has been in my head for as long as I like music, perhaps even before that. So layering, how are we going to turn this ID basically into a really cool sounding hardstyle lead? So this lead only really worked in Chesto with Secrets. They basically use the inner sound. It's very similar. It's a saw, but in hardstyle you want to have multiple saws. You want to have this big sauce of saws, you know. So here's how to do it. Here's one way how to do it with my bank. So let's copy it over here to a second pattern and let's start layering. So first important thing, you might want to know what kind of sound you're looking for. If you are looking for a very happy, the tweakers type sound, or perhaps a bit headhunters, you can go with a square, with a pulse. So I use this one a lot. I think it's a really cool sound, but we still are not there. So I'm going to use this one, but not as my main lead. For my main lead, I want to have this raw bus type sound. So I don't know, I renamed some of them. Secret Savannah is a really cool one. So there are not really any gliding notes in here. And it's very static now, so I'm going to enable the portamento, the auto glide. Okay, let's have a look at the MIDI. I always make sure there's this little bit of space between the notes. Yeah, it sounds more rhythmical. so this might be a bit too much. Let's lower it down a little bit. It's on the details. So for those who have watched my previous tutorial how to make stuff punchy or not, in this case we might not want to make it too punchy. It's more of a feeling melody, I think. Well, we can go both ways, but I'm going to make it smooth or neutral even. So that. Now let's layer. So here's something I always do when I start layering. I turn my master channel to mono. Here's the thing, this is really important. When you are layering leads in stereo, it will always sound worse in mono. But when you are layering in mono, it will always sound better in stereo. Or almost always. So if you want to make sure your leads still sound sort of nice when your phone has one speaker or when whatever happens, I really recommend start layering in mono. Because this also makes it, it gives you a stronger lead sound in the end. So now, this is on mono. I usually don't do it this way. I have this Mackie Big Knob controller. I simply click mono and it's on mono. It's not really that fancy, but it's really nice. And I also switch to my Yamahas when I do this. Because of the bigger mid-range. They don't sound as pretty as my KRKs, so that allows me to focus better. I hope this makes sense. So let's copy it to lead number 2. So what would be a nice next lead? So the important thing here is when you add another lead, you should hear the difference when you turn it off. So sure, we hear a difference now, but this is just doubling the volume because it's the same sound. Let's go with a super saw. Smooth saw. Sharp saw maybe? What's sharp saw? Nope, not that one. Lost World might be cool. I named it Smooth Saw. Pretty sure of that. Might be here somewhere. Yes! Okay, doesn't sound that bad in mono. This one is going to be a really big game changer when you switch back to stereo. So let's see how this sounds when we layer it. Nice. Okay, let's turn the autoglide on. Cool. So, and now also the other thing I like about this, when I am mixing in mono, it's always this surprise factor. You're doing a lot of work on your melody, but once you switch back to stereo, it's like, oh my god, this sounds so much better. So, yeah. Lead number 3. So, we have this main lead sound, and we have the support lead, which makes it bigger and stronger. What could we possibly add next? Let's say we make some sort of another type of bus sound. I use this one in my Oxygen remake. Okay, let's see how these go together. Alright. Perhaps in this case, because the other leads don't have a lot of release, let's turn it down a bit. Doesn't have to be perfect, but all right. Now in this case, you might want to add some more leads or not. But this is already a pretty strong main lead. You'll hear that in a minute. So let's go to lead 4. Let's do the final thing. Let's add a pulse. I don't always add a pulse, but in this case might be nice. Just hear the difference. So there's not really a big difference in sound, but you can hear it sounds stronger. The thing with the pulse is very mono in this case. There is nothing that makes it stereo, so there's only one voice, there's no chorus. This one will sound exactly the same in mono as in stereo. So now, when we switch back, it should sound really cool. So this is mono. Let's go to stereo. I think that's nice. Let's go back to mono again. Let's start working on the other layers. Now, as you might have seen in my videos, I usually don't do this with lead 2, 3, 4. I blank them out because I add the lead to the mixer. Let's show you. Let's add everything to the mixer. And I want to combine all the leads because they are basically, they should become one sound. So that's why. Now, let's start working on the harmony. So what type of sound, what type of lead are we going to use for the harmony? Now, let's go back. No, let's grab this one here. Harmony 1. All right, so the harmony is basically, they are more like the chords than the main lead. The main lead, that's your melody. That's the thing people are going to remember, remind, or find catchy or not. The harmonies simply make it sound more euphoric, more big, more amazing, but they are not that important. So you can go crazy with them. They may completely die in mono or whatever. So let's grab a really big lead smooth saw. Let's make it a bit dirtier, maybe, by doing this. Right, and let's do that with the other saw too. Okay, so there's a preset completely like this, I think, in my bank, but this is the quick way around. So I'm going to do the same thing for harmony 2, so let's delete harmony 2, clone this one, saves us a bit of time, and make sure it's in the right mixer track. And let's throw harmony 2 in there. Oh shit. Alright, so here's harmony 2, and as you can see, it's on the top. I usually transpose it down, so that there's one harmony above the main lead and one below. I don't know why, but it seems to work. I also think the harmony 1 is the most important one. The second one should be lower in volume a bit. So when we play this, it should sound, shouldn't sound that bad. But when you listen to it, the main lead is already disappearing because of the harmonies. So let's do it here. Let's lower the harmonies. Alright, now let's do the chords. So I'm going to copy the chords, pasting them here. Let's listen to them. Cool. Let's find a nice chord preset. So for those who don't know how my bank works again, you can use leads for this, but most of the leads are on legato mode, so you have to switch that off. But I made some special chord presets. This one is very 90s. Doesn't really work for this. Rust, I don't know. It's pretty rusty. This one is very basic. Let's go with heady chords. Heady chords always work. Or classic overkill. Alright, I like that one. Let's see if it works. Now let's do the same thing with the chords. Let's clone it, name it chords 2. Normally I use my Spire bank. So in my Silent One bank there's also a little Spire bank with presets I use a lot. I actually remade the Spire chords in Silent almost identical. But I forgot about the name, so you'll have to figure that out. Lovely. That's my bank. The filler. Oh, it's also called the filler in my Silent One thing, I believe. Infection. Might be infection, actually. Cool. Let's disable the reverb, delay, and the release. Let's throw it down a bit. Because we are going to do that externally in the mixer. Let's see if they match, if they improve each other. That's the point. Cool. Now, final thing, let's do the bass line and start mixing. So, bass line, bam. For this one, We can go with a sub bass line that follows this rhythm, or we can do it like this. I'm going to grab Oxy Bass because it's the bass I made for the Oxygen remake. Oh, it's a bit low. Okay, let's see how this sounds. And let's lower the volumes a bit because it's starting to clip now. So that's basically how I do it. That's basically the tutorial already. So let's not leave it like this. Let's mix it a little bit. So let's go back to stereo right now. And here's our end result as far as the layering goes. This was mono. And I honestly think it's a strong melody in mono. Now this should be way much better. So yeah, very nice. So, the mixing. How are we going to do that part? Well, I have shown you this before, but let's do it again. I usually make this melody bus. And make it purple. Because, yeah, who doesn't like the color of death and funerals? Yay! It basically reminds me of the voice of D-Tunes when he does tutorials. So, here's our melody. When we turn it off... not really much of a melody. Let's turn off the bass line because we are going to focus on the melody only. But for now, let's turn off the chords and everything else too, because this is about the lead. So first thing, I'm going to remove some low. I'm going to grab the FabFilter Pro Q3. You don't need Pro Q3. You can even do this with the one or with the FL Studio, whatever thing. So you might want to ask me why I don't do this brick wall cut. Now that's because I like to leave in some of the low, so it sounds more natural. And I don't do a high boost yet, we can do this in the melody bus eventually. So now that we have done this, let's go compress it with the CLA-3A Stereo, which is a really cheap compressor by Waves and it's also really easy to use. Yeah, so it's basically already done. So I think it sounds better now. I won't do this with the Harmony 1 and 2. Perhaps. Perhaps the EQ. So let's copy this EQ. Nothing that special. Now the chords. Let's treat them with a little EQ 2. Haha, EQ 2 and it's a Fab Pro Q3. That's basically it. Now let's throw the chords down a bit because it's all about the lead. Let's not forget the lead. Should lead. It's a leader. Most important guy in the club right here. So let's give him all space and all ears. Now just to make it a bit more nice, let's throw in a quick pad. Hey, you know what we're going to use for that, you know? Hercules. Fuck it, you know, this Paul Dino guy, this really reminds me of Marlboro, you know, the cigarettes. Okay, so let's not look at it that much. By the way, funny enough, Hercules 2 is working at the moment. I had this major bug and I'm so happy it worked. Yeah, that's a story for another time. So let's find a nice pad. This is extremely Terminator. Okay, this should work. Let's find a different pad. Maybe this one. Yeah. All right, so it's a bit fast now. So let's do Control A and Control G, gluing all the notes that are basically the same together. Nice. So Hercules, yeah, let's leave the name because it's my own VST, you know, I'm very proud of it. I use it a lot. I actually have a lot of fun with it, remaking analog stuff, but yeah, I should show you guys this more. Okay, maybe a bit of reverb, but not a lot. And now we are going to sidechain the melody to the pads. Let's enable everything and let's disable the melody going to the master. And let's sidechain it. I'm going to use track spacer, but you can do this with Fruity Limiter. Now what track spacer does again, it only sidechains on the frequencies present in the sidechain signal. It's basically makes everything less messy. So let's see if this works at all. Nice. And just remember, there's not even reverb and delay yet. So let's do that quickly before the tutorial gets boring. Vampire verb, okay. And vampire delay. Vampire, yeah. So what's that? You'll see. Another new track. Okay. 1/8 maybe. Let's turn those guys off and let's focus on this. So, limit the problem, threshold down. Nice. Okay, let's do the reverb. Okay, it's cool. But let's EQ the reverb a bit because there's too much mid, for my opinion. Something like this. So you know what, I'm going to share this exact FLP. You might not have FabFilter Pro Q3 for Hella Room or Track Spacer, but I'm going to share this FLP in my Silent One bank, which is updated and really big at the moment. So it's free. Soon there will be a template pack, but for now, this is a really nice melody to have fun with maybe. So check it out, link in the description. This is what we have right now.